Okay, it was quite a while back, but during the first presentation in the Steve Jobs Theater on the new Apple campus, the company announced new iPhones for 2017, but I personally got more excited about the public release of iOS 11, mostly because it brings some much-needed improvements to the iPads. Thanks to those, many more people are gonna be able to replace their traditional computers with these lightweight tablets. True, it doesn't bring anything the industry hasn't seen. In fact, most of the features had been available on Windows devices for quite a long time. Hopefully, that statement won't start a war in the comments because I'm very glad Apple is finally adopting these features. The first one being the new dock. It can now store up to 13 apps for quick access. That's because it isn't available only on the home screen, but a short swipe up from the bottom edge of the display brings it out system-wide for quick app switching. If you want to, you can enable the most recent apps and suggested apps, like handoff from other devices, to be listed in a separate section of the dock, changing the multitasking experience from fast to even faster. Speaking of multitasking, it is totally different. And better. First of all, the user interface has been completely redesigned. Open apps are presented as these cards, with the old control center with settings like brightness, do not disturb, orientation lock, etc. being integrated as well. Also, if you open apps in split view, or in other words, two apps side by side, the app pair remains a single card. This approach is similar to how macOS handles spaces. Other than that, it is also possible to open apps in a narrow window which floats over the main full screen app. This is called slide over, but unlike in iOS 10, it doesn't freeze the main app and the window can be placed on either side of the screen. This is, for example, handy to quickly see an entire message conversation while doing something else. To bring the smaller app into split view, you just quickly swipe down on the top handle. Drag and drop is the one feature which perfectly complements the multitasking capabilities. However, in this aspect, Apple exceeded our expectations. Selecting and dragging multiple items, especially on a touchscreen, can be a bit of a pain, because you need to have all the stuff arranged just right. Luckily, it is possible to use one finger to start dragging the first item, while using your other finger to add more items you want to drag at once, while using your other hand to seamlessly navigate the rest of the operating system. Let me show that again. First item, more items, different app, and drop. Improvements in the area of inking is something Microsoft has been pushing hard, and me being a student, I use these features on a daily basis. On the iPad, books and PDFs can now be annotated right in iBooks using the same tools present in the Notes app. Screenshots follow the same idea, but finally, they do not get saved to the camera roll straight away. Instead, you get a small preview in the lower left-hand corner where you can crop or further adjust and annotate the screenshot or just share it without saving it at all. And it works the same way on the iPhones as well. I am sure this thing alone will help many people keep their camera roll at least somewhat organized. For eager note takers, it is also possible to start taking notes right from the lock screen without having to unlock the iPad. Just tap the Apple Pencil and start putting down your ideas. Unfortunately, this only works with the built-in Notes app. After years of begging Apple, we finally have an app dedicated to handling files. Sort of like the Finder on Mac. Sort of. You see, the problem is, it integrates your cloud accounts and the local storage, and it is nicely optimized for touch use, but it just doesn't allow you to do enough stuff. It is still impossible to freely structure files in the local storage, because the grouping is still solely app-based. Similarly, it also isn't possible to just plug in an external device, like a USB drive, to transfer documents or media. Of course, if I wanted to cover everything new, this video would be more than a couple of minutes long. But just to briefly mention some other noteworthy improvements. Scanning documents is now natively built into the Notes app. QR codes can be read using the stock camera app, and the new keyboard makes it faster to access commonly used special characters by swiping down on given keys. Again, like Microsoft Touch keyboard since the Windows 8 days. Do not get me wrong, I'm very glad Apple included these features, because as much as I like my Surface, it is a tad unreliable at times. And given my previous experience with iPads, Apple will probably try a bit harder to iron out the bugs as soon as possible. If anything, this is a prime example of why competition is a good thing. I'm keeping my fingers crossed that this trend will further continue with iOS 12. I might upload an iOS 12 wishlist video, but in the meantime, let me know whether there's anything specific you would like to see added in the future releases of iOS.